What's y'all names? I didn't even catch y'all
names. I'm Lycan. This is
Michael.
Lycan. But my actual real name is Michael, though.
Yeah. Yeah. And now I'm AMENZ, but my real name is Anthony.
Yeah. Yep.
AMENZ?
Yeah. It's like, it's our our nicknames that we just fire YouTube.
Aliases. Yeah. So people won't stalk us.
That's dope. You guys don't YouTube aliases?
Yeah, oh, definitely.
Yeah, for
definitely.
Sure.
Anybody can have an alias. Really?
Yeah, yeah,
I mean, mine's age of
12
or
B,
so I get it.
Yeah.
Age of
12
is pretty good.
Yeah. Like I never left.
Heard what she said.
We got a couple questions here we're gonna ask you.
Yep.
You know, so you wanna go ahead and start with the first
one. So what anime shows are you currently watching at this moment right now?
Currently, I've just been heavy in the DBZ, but I've been getting recommendations like Naruto.
Oh yeah.
I know Naruto's fire. And then like I wanna get in the full Metal Alchemist. Yeah. But I haven't really been in like watching animes lately. I've been in Zero Dark 30 training.
Yeah.
So like for me, like I don't watch TV. I don't. Everything right now is like I wake up,
train.
I get straight to it.
Yeah.
And I'm finding something to do, whether it's mental training as far as like I listen to my audiobook Relentless, then I'll go from that, go to a training session, go to PT, or go to PT to go to a training session, come home. Catch between 500 and 1500 bars a day, and I pool and swim. And once I swim, I get about 20 laps in my pool. And I make sure I get some type of treatment, therapy, massage. Usually by the time I'm done, it's like 8 o'clock. So I do that pretty much every day.
That's wild, bro.
I know, but people don't understand. Like I don't really talk about it. I don't really show it off.
Yeah.
The only reason I'm telling y'all is
because
y'all
through
the PD,
I
see you cool.
Okay.
So how far did you see all of Dragon Ball, or like you finished?
I watch all of them.
Yeah.
All of them, like throughout my life, like I rewatch so many different ones, and everything like that.
Right.
So you seen the Super?
I love that. Yeah, I seen the Super.
Okay.
Yeah. Did you like it?
I loved it. I thought it was cool. I thought it was like different to try to, you know what I'm saying, understand like, oh, they're parallel universes, right?
Yeah.
You got certain people that do these certain things that match you, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, so it was like, oh, say like the black girl, you know what I'm saying? Like, cool shit like that. Like, oh, that shit different. Like, you don't think about, oh.
He actually was fired.
Like, you don't think about Jaren, like, being that ultimate, and then you don't think about Grandson, or like, oh, shit, you got somebody that's even proud. Then that erased people. You know
right.
Just kept going like
this.
Like levels. Just top of level.
Exactly.
Who's your favorite?
Seeing them reach close instinct, and it's like, oh, wow, there's a level above that where it's just your body, natural, instinctual. And you can relate that to, you know, being human for real. Like, when you train or when you do stuff, thing, or when you, anything that you do on the impulse is instinctual. You know what I mean? You don't have to think about it. You don't have to. Do it like for instance, like what's one of y'all favorite things to do, like when y'all chilling?
Mine is just to come up with theories of stuff. So I kind of like the gang understanding about things.
Like, so you like coming up with theories, right?
Pretty much.
All right. So that, like I said, it comes up to you naturally because it's what you like to do. It's what you're passionate about.
Right.
So
right.
It's instinctual. You know what I'm saying? Like you don't have to think.
Yeah, we're dropping out. I'm right.
That's crazy. Yeah.
I got that written down. Put it in my mind pad or whatever you call it.
That's crazy, bro. Like, when I be thinking about instinct, I be thinking about it's like protection in a sense. Like if something's happening, I'm instinctually like
born.
Yeah.
Because that's your natural state. That's what you feel like, oh, whoa, I got something about that. Oh shit, I gotta react. Like
right.
You snap out of it, like you don't know how the hell I did that. That shit instantly.
Yeah.
You have to
you do that all the time on the field then, huh?
Exactly. That's what football is.
Yeah.
Able to train your instincts to just react at all times and be ultra instinct.
Yes, sir.
You feel me?
I see how you feel about it.
Little details. So right. It's instinctual.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you remember, like, when and how you were, like, first introduced to anime?
Oh, well, when I was young. I mean, I used to watch cartoons all day, and then I remember, like, from a kid. But I remember, like, watching Dragon Ball Z when I was young, like, third grade. It was, like, me and my friends used to go third, fourth grade. Used to go home at 5:30.
Yes,
5:30 every day.
Yes, sir.
The house we was going to.
Yeah, for real.
It was just lit. And we used to try to power up at the bus stop.
Hey, for real, though.
And I remember that.
That stuff got hype.
So far, do you happen to have like three top favorite anime, or like is it mostly just Dragon Ball right now?
Mm-hmm. I'm just right now mostly in the Dragon Ball. I want to expand. Like I need.
Oh, there's tons of stuff out there. Trust. If you need some recommendations, we can give you a list.
I need some. Yeah, please.
A nice list.
I need some because when I get the time, like for instance, like, I'll be watching anime sometimes when I'll just be. You know, traveling or chilling or whatever the case may be.
Right.
Yeah. So it gives me like even though right now I'm in Zero Dark 30, but when I have more balance, like I get it.
Yeah.
I need my show. Also watch it. Connect my mind to or something like that.
Right.
So it's like the Zero Dark 30 thing. Is that mostly like from point A date to the next date, and that's it?
Like it's so like yeah, it's like for instance, so like. I had major ankle surgery. I fucked it up during the season last year. I tore it up pretty good. Tore the deltoid ligament on the inside. And then another ligament on my outside. But I only missed one game and I was playing with it the whole time.
Dang.
So I had high ankle. So a scar right there.
Dang.
And then I got a scar right here. So my ankle got rotated that way, and I tore this ligament here off.
Yeah.
Dang. So it was like a pretty major surgery, but like they said it was supposed to be like a 3 to 6 month recovery, and closer to 6 months. They had to say 4 to 6 months, close to 6 months. And I looked at it, I'm like, nah, like.
Yeah.
It's not
going to
take you six, it's probably take you 3 or 4.
Right.
And,
Iron Man strength.
You know your body.
Yeah.
Right, I know my body. And I was like, well, this is a major surgery. We kind of did trust me, like, y'all don't know. Like,
right.
But I got my mind on something, like.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, when you speak that stuff, man.
Speak it to existence.
It happens.
So I went Zero Dark 30.
Y'all hear him loud and clearly. Uses as an example.
But next question is, what kind of principles did your parents instill in you at an early age that you now use with your own son? You see how the son, so.
With him, I just try to still just, like, if, you know, if you're going to do something, finish it. Like, don't ever quit on something that you finish it.
Facts.
And then, you know, always treat others how you want to be treated, with respect.
Right. Same. Like, I live highly to that.
You know, it don't cost much to be respectful and kind.
Yeah.
So I always try to do that. And then on top of that, I just try to lead by example. I just try to show them, like, show them things, teach them, talk to them, communicate it. I just tell them to talk to them, communicate it. Like, he's a grown up ever since he was a kid. So he's able to articulate, understand things, and, you know, do things on his own, but I just try to teach him all the little basic stuff, and lead by example, like hard, work hard. If you say something, you know, say you're going to do it, just don't say something, just say it. Do things with intent. Just don't do stuff that to do it. Like, time is very valuable. Don't waste your time.
Yeah.
Don't be diligent with things you do. But, you know, it's just like be intentional with your work. Like, facts. You know, you got things that you're passionate about. Just do things without, you know, passion. Like, there's certain passionate things that you do it intentional. Like, every work that I do, every time I work out, I do it intentional.
Yeah, okay. That's what's up. Did your, like, mental, like, how did your mentality change, like, before you had your kid and then after? Because my wife and I, like, we looking to get a baby soon, so it's like, it's like I don't know what
well,
to
expect. The thing is, it's like, when before you have a kid and after you have kids, for some reason, just something changes. The thing is, like, because now you go from having no work, you always, like, the primal instinct of humans is self-preservation, you know? Like, we try to preserve ourselves, we try to make sure we're good for everybody else,
right?
So, like, when you go from that and you have a whole life that you have to take care of, from yours to you have to protect your own, like, protect your son or somebody else before, your perspective, everything on life changes. So you go from thinking about, self, to, all right, I got to make sure that I'm doing something for that person first before I do something for myself.
Yeah, that's what's up.
So, I mean, you
dropping knowledge today.
Yeah. Let's do
dropping knowledge today.
You get to the next question.
Okay. Okay.
I'm like, hey, that was good.
Dropping knowledge.
Good.
Okay. So,
we just conversating. That's all. Yeah. You know, make conversations.
Though. I'm definitely using everything out here today. Trust
for
me.
For real.
Man, I'm like, dang, man. I need to be doing more. Like, what is going on?
You can always do more.
Yeah.
That's the thing. There's always more to be done. Like, I'm always figuring out a way to just better myself every day, mentally, physically, emotionally.
Thanks.
Any moment I get, because think about it, like right now, this conversation we're having, Zoom call, words we're speaking, we're not going to get those again.
Right.
So it's what you do after, you know what I'm saying? It's like what you do with them. Like what are you going to do to better yourself in the next 20 minutes, 30 minutes, hour, 2 hours? You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Everybody talks about, I didn't have enough time, I didn't have this. Everybody has the same 24 hours.
You can always do better. Like, even us sitting here talking to you, like took an email from Lycan to just reach out, you know what I'm saying, and take a risk. And now we're, like, trying to do something better, you
weird.
Know, so.
Still weird feeling.
Every day.
Still weird feeling.
You got to go for stuff in life,
It's still weird that they responded. Like we just sitting there, like, they actually responded. But, like, if, like, we could have recorded how, like, excited we was about, like, this avenue opening, we were just,
crazy.
Like.
Crazy.
Wait, we read it, even. So that was just wild.
I was like, hell yeah, I love just talking, you know, just conversating with people down there, bro. Because at the end of the day, like, I can learn stuff from you as much as you can learn from me. Like, God gives us two eyes so we can see, understand things, two ears so we can hear and speak in one mouth. You know what I'm saying? Like, spoke when it's time for you to speak or when it's time for you to be heard, but you need to listen and see and understand.
Exactly.
That stuff meant the world to us, man. Literally, just telling my family about it, stuff like that was just like, cool. I was like, dang.
I was walking around, my chest poked out.
Even though, technically, I'm like a diehard Saints fan, but
and,
I'm cool.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, just a little joke in that.
I play for who I play for, and you know what I'm saying? Like, that's my team. I love my team and everything like that. At the end of the day, like, I love people that are fans of the game.
Definitely.
Who's your team? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I can get traded
tomorrow,
you know, and shit happens.
Right.
It's the love and the passion of the game. Like, my love for the game never changes. Like,
facts.
Like, why I do it don't change.
Yeah.
Wherever I play, I'm still giving my all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, never, where you are, the location of your passion, it shouldn't matter. Like,
facts.
Your passion
won't
be your passion, no matter where you at.
Yeah.
So, pretty much. You pretty much made it as a successful NFL wide receiver. When you were younger, did you kind of see yourself pretty much excelling in a different position? Or did you kind of always have that vision?
Yeah, the funny thing is, like, growing up as a kid, like, I always wanted to play receiver.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, kids can throw, like, you know what I'm saying? Everybody young,
man.
Like, had the arm. So, you like, I had to play. I started out playing running back. And I went running back to playing quarterback. Because it's like, you're just more athletic and you want ball in hands all the time. And I was pretty nice at quarterback.
Oh, yeah.
So, like,
we've seen a couple throws. We've seen a couple throws. Come on now.
So, like, from my eighth grade on, I played quarterback and defense and safety. But point where I was better at safety.
Okay.
I should have been checking on those.
No, you good. Gotta get that grub too.
Yeah, but I just always like, I just knew like, for me, I made my mind up that I was going to be in a league when I was nine, like, do whatever I can to make, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
But I didn't classify myself as a player.
Right.
Whatever it is that I need to do, whatever it is that I need to be, I'm a master. I love the game. Like,
right.
No matter where I'm playing it from.
Man, that's what's up.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what's
up. My mindset was to like, just because, like, for instance, like, you're artists, right? You paint whatever you want. You know what I'm saying? You don't, right. Like, oh, only paint this, only paint that. Like, only.
Yeah, that's true.
How you feel.
Right.
Dang.
You know? So.
That's crazy because you think the players, they just stuck to that same position all their life and all of that. Like, that's really not the case. So.
I feel it. I don't feel as much as you, but when I was in high school, I was playing like 7 different positions, and it was kind of annoying for me because I was always on the field tired,
yeah.
And I could never get no Gatorade. Mm-hmm. I wanted to get
I go from quarterback to safety to return to punt. All right.
Dang.
Just on the field.
On the field.
Dang. Woo.
Yeah.
My hat goes off. I had one. It will go off to you. It will go off to you.
Next question, do you have any, like, anime moves you still find yourself, like, doing to this day? Or something, like, playing around, like, do, like, a command?
Oh, every time I command a man, I'm on the
way. Walking down the street, just like, what you say?
Real quick.
For real.
I may have blasted before you even know it.
Poop somebody at the gas station to do that.
Somebody walking by. Look at me,
like,
real quick.
It's like, as you said that, it was this video of this black kid going Super Saiyan that just, like, pretty much ran in my head. I'm going to send Patrick the link. It's pretty much him going Super Saiyan and screaming for a long time. And then his hair is, like, the gold hair.
Yeah, gold, yeah.
But it's
yeah.
a towel or, like, a shirt or it's something like that. Yeah. It's hilarious. It's hilarious. Next appreciate question we got. So this is kind of like a scenario, right? If you were to introduce a previous teammate between Chad Johnson and Julio Jones, who would you have an easier time having them pretty much watch anime or, like, adopt it? So who would you have a better chance at getting them to watch anime?
I don't know. I mean, I would say Chad would probably be more into it,
mm-hmm.
but Julio would watch it.
Okay.
I feel like Chad would probably be more into it, but Julio would definitely watch it.
Okay.
Like Julio ain't opposed to it, but I wouldn't say that's his preference.
Yeah. Preference? Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, we're about to move to the next question. We should probably, yeah.
You got 3 more. So, out of your entire football career, what would you say is your most personal favorite moment?
Out of a few, I would say my personal favorite moment, I'd say probably one. You might be mad, I'm sorry. But it's like I scored the game with a touchdown versus Saints and had the ball to my son. This is after I had tore my MCL in the game, but I kept playing because he was at the game.
Dang,
and I didn't want to not come out the game, you know.
So and a lot of people don't know that. That's crazy.
Oh, nobody will never know that.
Hats off.
I felt it pop, but I didn't come out.
That's like some MJ flu games though.
The game, my touchdown.
That's crazy. Like I could just imagine your son getting old and just watching that.
It's a proud moment.
Like, man.
That's like the MJ flu game type stuff. Like, legendary moments, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like I didn't expect that answer. I did not expect that answer at all.
Yeah.
I'm about to do the same thing when I get a son. As soon as I get one. All right, the second one. So, who is your favorite anime waifu?
Wife?
Mm-hmm. So it's like
I would say either Gigi or Bulma, because Bulma be talking shit, she be crazy, but Gigi, she don't give a fuck.
Gigi don't care.
You know what I'm saying? Like Gigi don't care.
Yeah.
Gigi like, do not
Gigi
care.
Say what's on her mind. Like, and Bulma, she be talking reckless to all the villains. Like they
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, she do.
Reckless
as fuck, like
she be like,
she always got Vegeta.
Right, she got Vegeta.
Hey, Vegeta made a good choice to me.
But she be letting Goku just go train for a year or two.
Come yeah. back. She's like very open.
She's open. Don't die for 6 years and come back.
You know, right. Like, hey. I don't think Boma going though. Yeah, she's like, nah, you gotta come back tonight.
That's my wife, bro.
You need to help her back at 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock on the dot. 7 o'clock.
Finally, I need you back.
It's the last question, man. Last question. If you could be any anime character, who would it be and why?
I don't know. I would say Vegeta. I wouldn't say Goku, because Goku, I got Vegeta tattooed on me.
Ah, dang, he way more of a fan than I.
You gotta step your game up.
I got a photo of Vegeta in my phone.
You gotta step your game up.
I was gonna get a tattoo later.
Like, the one thing about Vegeta, like, he has his pride gets in the way, but at the same time, it's what fuels him, you know? Like, there's one thing, like, he starts off bad and everything like that, but he grows and he learns, like, he learns about himself. He learns how to love and care. Yeah. And, you know, it's like, shit, it ain't just about me.
Right.
And that's the cool part. You learn about Vegeta. It's like, over time, he becomes a good guy.
Yeah.
One of the most powerful motherfuckers.
Yeah. Definitely got like, one of the biggest character developments in all of anime.
That's true.
Right.
Yeah, that's true.
And the best armor. The best style. The
toughest armor. He looks the sweetest.
He just be the battle armor, just chilling. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get my Vegeta tat tomorrow. You gotta
go crazy, dude.
You gotta
send it
to me when you get it. I gotta.
Huh? I was just playing, but you know, I could probably get his.
I got space for Goku.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man. All right. So we appreciate you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? No giving this time. We know you gotta go eat. We got one last part. If you don't have you ever heard of the anime called The Avatar?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, you know, they got, like, the different nations. They got the Fire Nation, Water Nation, Earth. Okay. Earth. So, we need you to pick which nation are you rocking with?
Which one am I rocking with?
Yep.
You can choose one.
Which LJ
one?
Collier said that he rocking with the Stone Nation. Rock Nation? Yeah.
The Rock Nation?
Yep.
Yeah.
So, we just wondering.
I can't pick the Avatar.
You can, but we kind of need you to pick one of the sides.
Yeah.
For like
I would pick the Water Nation. Just how I am. Just shit that just flow. I don't ever whatever going on. You feel me? Like, I ain't like, oh, just what we doing now. Right, let's go with it.
So we 0 for 2. We 0 for 2 right now.
Yeah.
Because we have our sub bait. Our sub base on YouTube, we call them the Fire Nation. So we like Fire Nation Squad. So every question
I love the Fire Nation.
You know,
we just want some love, man.
See, I think the bad thing was that we kind of picked the villains in the anime, and it was kind of bad.
But that's the thing, though. You have to, the villains you gotta have the good side and the dark side.
Yep.
The yin and the yang. Yin and yang.
Yeah.
Everybody got a good side. Everybody got a dark side.
True.
Yeah.
How you able to coexist with them?
That's
you got to understand yourself. Understand who you are on both sides. Good side and a dark. And then be right in the middle. You get too high and never get too low.
That's crazy, man.
For
real. Like, real talk.
The dark side is the side that fuels you to be passionate. Fuels you to do stuff. You don't even know it.
Damn.
If I was like, when somebody tell you can't do something, what happens to you? Like, if I you can't
get
do
a fuel.
Like, what?
Right.
Because that's your dark side. That's your.
Yeah.
That's like,
yeah.
You know, and it happens like that.
That's new over here dropping knowledge.
What people see constantly, like, hey, you sweet, smile. Well, when it's time to get to it, you lose focus. That's your dark side.
That's crazy.
So, Prima, before we conclude this, even though you're rocking with the Water Nation, which is perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. Do you got anything else to like say to our viewers?
Fan base.
Yes.
Y'all keep just betting yourself every day for real. Just do one thing. Spend 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
You catch 1,000 balls every day. 1,000.
Football, man.
I'm all right. Well, we already at 1,300. I started early today. Yeah.
Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Well, what a football.
You got it over there.
Where?
Football, tennis ball, whatever.
Yeah.
Catch is a catch.
Facts.
It's right there. Does this count?
That's a catch.
There's one.
Didn't even catch?
On the catch?
I can't even catch.
You can't throw. You heard what he said. People can't throw.
Catch you right in your hand.
Right? Fumbling.
One.
We're going to work on that. We're going to work on that.
We're going to have 1,000 by the time next time we talk to you.
It can't be any just type of catch. It's got to be intentional. That'd be perfect.
And a good thrower, too. Throw that. Make sure you throw that in there. Good throw.
A good thrower. I don't know. It looked like it hit you right in your hand.
You know, the way the camera was looking.
The way the camera was looking, looked like it hit you right in your fingers.
I was gonna go to the tryouts too, but hey, I guess I can't do that anymore.
Man, appreciate you, man. God bless you, man. You and the family. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you so much.
Wish nothing but the best for you and the career and everything.
Yeah, do it again sometime.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Keep Have a touch. great season. Hope your family stay healthy too.
Facts.
Appreciate y'all.
I'm definitely gonna use stuff that you told us today, man. That stuff was inspirational, honestly.
All right, bro.
Learned a lot.
Sure. We'll be in contact.
We'll do.
Talk to y'all fellas soon.
All righty.
Yes, sir.
Y'all be safe. Tell the families I said hello.
Grandma, you heard him?
Grandma and mama.
I'm going to go tell my grandma.
Cousin Steve.
I'm going to go find me a cousin Steve just to say I got one. You heard him talking to him. Appreciate it, man.
Take it easy, bro.
No doubt, bro.
All right.
Be easy.
You too.